Please come and take a seat. Welcome to my kitchen. Sit yourself down, make yourself comfortable. That's it, great. So, you said on the phone that you were wanting to place an order for a cake. Uh-huh. Well, you've certainly come to the right place. So, let me take a few details from you to begin with. Have you been here before? No? No, I didn't think I recognised you. But that's not a problem. Don't worry about that at all. I'll just need to take down a couple of details to put you on the system. And then we can go through your ideas. So, let me just grab a pen. Okay. So, what's your name? Okay, and your address? Hmm? And your postcode? Lovely. So you're not that far then, you didn't have too far to come. Excellent. And what's the best number to contact you on? Okay, that's not a problem. Thank you very much. Now, with regards to the cake, what is the date that you would require it for? What's the date of your celebration? Mm-hmm. Okay. Uh-huh. Okay. So, what is the occasion? Is it a christening? Or a birthday, or a wedding. We cater for pretty much every occasion that you can think of. Mm-hmm. You've maybe seen some of our work online. Yeah? Oh, thank you. It's very kind of you to say. Okay. That's good. And will you be having a party? Is it being held at a venue? Or is it just going to be a party at home? At a venue, okay. Do you know roughly how many people you're going to be catering for? How many people will be coming to the party? Hmm. Okay. Definitely be needing a venue then, or a very, very large house. Okay. Yeah, it does help us to know how many people are going to be there, because it helps us to work out how large a cake you will need so that everybody gets a piece. Yeah, yeah. Okay, so by the sounds of things, you're going to need quite a large cake. Uh-huh. Well, are you thinking maybe a tiered cake? Or one really big cake? Or a hand-carved cake? Or... You're not sure yet. Okay, no, that's fine. That's not a problem at all. Okay. So, do you have a colour scheme or a theme for the occasion? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Sounds good. Okay. And did you have any ideas of how you wanted the finished cake to look? Any ideas for the design? The shape of the cake. Okay. Mm-hmm. Oh, you've got some samples. You've got some photos. Yeah, yeah, sure. Let me see. Thanks. Cool. Okay. Yeah, that could work. I like the design on that one. That's lovely. Okay. Yeah, well, I'm sure we can incorporate those into the design. Can I keep hold of those? Lovely. And were you wanting any wording on the cake or on the board? Mm-hmm. You can have names if it is obviously just for one person or for a couple. You can have a monogram. Some people even opt to have a quote on the board. It gives us more space to put it on the cake board itself. If it's a short quote, then it can go on the cake. Depends on what you're wanting, really. Okay. Yeah. I'm liking your ideas. It's brilliant. It's lovely to speak to somebody that has an idea in mind as to what they want. Excellent. So, moving on slightly to the inside of the cake, we have lots and lots of different flavours available for the sponge itself and for the filling. So, some examples for the sponge would be, obviously you have the traditional vanilla sponge. You also have things like lemon, coconut. Mm-hmm. Yes, we can certainly do double chocolate. That's obviously a very popular one. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, if you have a tiered cake, you can actually have a different flavour on each tier. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so you could have a fruit cake on one layer, you could have a vanilla sponge on another, you could have a coconut and chocolate on another. Yeah, it's brilliant because then everybody gets catered for, lots of tastes get catered for. Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that would work. Yeah. That's good. Okay. And as for the filling, you have, again, you have different options with traditional sponge cake. A lot of people go for like a rich buttercream, often accompanied with jam. You can also go for flavoured buttercreams. So if you were having a chocolate cake, a chocolate sponge, you could have a vanilla buttercream, or you could have a chocolate buttercream. You could even have a mint flavoured buttercream. Totally, the options are absolutely limitless. We can totally cater it to your tastes and your needs. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, that's definitely possible, yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, you wouldn't believe some of the requests I get. No, that's fine. Okay. Do you have a budget in mind? You know, roughly how much you're wanting to spend? Uh-huh. You don't have to have an overall budget in mind if you know roughly per portion what you are willing to spend. Obviously, if you have a lot of guests attending and you're wanting each one of them to have a piece of the cake, that can be quite a good way of working out what the, you know, what you've got to spend. Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I can definitely work with that. Excellent. Now, do you have the address of the venue for me? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Oh, yes, yes, yes. And would the contact number be the same? Would it be yourself that I speak to if I have any other questions? Marvellous. Okay. And are the venue aware that we would be delivering the cake to them? Mm-hmm. And they're okay to store that for you? Okay. It doesn't always have to be stored. It depends on when you're having it delivered. We can sometimes deliver it immediately before the function is due to start. But just in case there's a couple of hours difference, they've got somewhere to keep it for you. Mm-hmm. Okay, so back to the description of the cake, your design ideas and things. As you still aren't entirely sure as to the type of cake that you want to go for, I've got a couple of photos here that I could show you of previous cakes that we've done. They're from all different occasions, but it gives you an idea of some of the different styles, and some of just the ideas of what's available and what's possible with cake and icing. So I have my computer here and we'll show you. So this here is a cake that we did for a christening. As you can see, it's a two-tier cake. And it has a modelled puppy dog on the top. Yep. And you can have, obviously there's the bunting. Got the bunting here. And all of the edging of the different colours. Obviously that particular customer wanted the cake just to be in those specific colours. So that's what we gave her. Yep, the puppy with the cupcake. You like that? He's cute, isn't he? Now this is a wedding cake. As you can see, this is one that has multiple tiers. Yeah, thank you. This happens to be one of my favourite cakes that I've made. Each layer was a different flavour. And these flowers on this level and on the bottom, they were all handmade specifically for the cake. We even went so far as to decorate the cake stand itself so that it matched and became part of the cake design. And obviously they've got a monogram at the top. No, the jewels aren't edible. Not on this cake anyway. They're just these ones around here, are bands of diamantes and beads that can just be taken off like a ribbon. And these ones are just pinned into the front so they can be removed. It was a very high cake. It was to feed a lot of people. Yes, it's beautiful, beautiful cake. I'd love to do something like that again in the future. Now this one is an example of a hand-carved 3D, sculpted cake. The little girl that this one was for, it was her birthday and she was absolutely mad about horses and ponies and horse riding. Yeah, so this was constructed out of sponge. Obviously, we don't have molds of this size and shape. This was made literally from scratch by myself. Very cute pony. We also do cakes that have movable parts. Obviously, this was for an over 18. You have the roulette wheel. The wheel itself actually moves. It was set onto a movable base so that the wheel could actually spin and make it look more realistic. So that's something else that we could do. Here we have one of our gravity-defying cakes. There's not really much to say about this other than we can make things appear like they're floating. So like the beer can, pouring beer into a large tankard. Lots of fun making these cakes and the possibilities for them are endless. We do themed cakes. Now this one is obviously a Doctor Who fan and the detail that goes into a cake like this is immense and It's even down to the handcrafted Dalek. We do pride ourselves on the detail that we put into our confectionery and cakes. Yep. And we do more fun cakes, something a little bit simpler for a children's Halloween party. Yeah. They can be made any size. The cakes are obviously totally customizable. Yep, and that's all the ones that I had to show you just now. So, do you have any more ideas now that you've seen a few photos? I'm giving you some inspiration, some food for thought. That's what we like to hear. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, so you could have the base layer and then the model on the top. We could carve that out for you. Yeah, sure. If you've got photographs of what it looks like, yeah, we can use those to structure the cake. Okay, let me just make a note of that. Lovely stuff. Okay, do you have any other questions? Okay, basically when the cake is carved, you'll just need to be very careful. Between the layers there will be plastic dowels. They look like solid straws that need to be removed when it's cut up. But each layer at the bottom will have boards between it. Yeah, so you'd have your cake board at the bottom, and then you'd have your base cake, and there would be the dowels in it, and there would be a thin board on the top before your next layer, and that board helps to take the weight of the cake on top, and the dowels make sure that the cake at the bottom doesn't squash. So yes, you do have to be very careful moving them. We would generally recommend that you take advantage of our delivery service, so that we can ensure that your cake reaches you in 100% perfect condition. But if you do need to pick it up yourself, or if you do need to move it, then just please, please keep it very level. Be very careful, because we don't want to have to come out at the last minute and try and fix it for you. So all that's really left to discuss is the deposit. It would be a 50% deposit. And we would call you 24 hours before your cake is due to be delivered and arrange the setup time. Yep. Okay, well, yep, that makes it easier. That's fine. So, yep. So we could set up from 4. Okay. And what we'll also do is provide you with boxes, so that when your function is finished, you're able to box up any cake that's left over and take that home to enjoy, yep, at your leisure. That's fine. So, is there anything else that you're wanting to ask? I think this is going to be an awesome cake. I'm really looking forward to designing it. What I would do, actually, while I think of it, could you give me your email address? How are you spelling that? What I will do then, I will go away just now and I will do some sketching. I will come up with a couple of different ideas for you to look at, and I will email those over to you. Once you've okayed the final design, I will phone you and we can take down some card details and get your deposit paid. That ensures your date in the diary. The deposit is non-refundable. If you should cancel for no reason, then yeah, the deposit would be kept. In the email, there'll be a copy of all of our terms and conditions, and it explains all of that in there. Okay. So yeah, I think I have all of the information I need. So I would just like to thank you very much for coming in to see me today. It has been an absolute pleasure speaking with you. And I look forward to getting your design sent to you really, really soon. Yeah, thank you. Oh, lovely to meet you. Thanks very much. Yeah, please come in again soon. Have a good day. Bye-bye.